Welcome to the John and Heidi Show podcast. Here's John and Heidi.
Today is a special day, Heidi. Do you know what today is?
What is today, John?
I thought you'd never ask. Today is Monday. It is the 13th day of September. National Kids Take Over the Kitchen Day today. That's cool.
You know, that's one thing I do regret is that I didn't spend more time making sure my kids were in the kitchen.
So our kids are both adults now, and they all they know how to cook is, well,
macaroni and cheese,
I can order
ramen.
Food off the internet and have them bring it to me. National Peanut Day. It's cool. Uncle Sam Day. I like that. National Celiac Disease Awareness Day.
We just have that one? I could have sworn we
National
just did a celiac.
No, it was a year. 1 year ago. Yeah. National Bald is Beautiful Day. National Boss/Employee Exchange Day. So if you want to swap jobs with your boss, today's the day.
Okay.
And Day of the Programmer. It's the 256th day of the year today. So that's why they do that. And in addition to all of that, it's also a Movie Star Monday. Our guest today is Susan Anton. She's been in several movies like Cannonball Run 2. She was even in one of the Sharknado movies, Heidi.
Oh, you gotta love those.
Baywatch. She was on Baywatch. Anyway, we're going to be chatting with Susan Anton coming up in a bit.
Addiction. It's not a pretty thing. Addiction can lead to many problems in your life. Addiction can drive away those who love you the most. And addiction can lead to the loss of jobs, relationships, and even your life. Don't let addiction tear your life apart anymore. Get the help you need to defeat addiction and put the pieces back together in your life. Learn more at timeforrehab.com. They want to help. Timeforrehab.com. That's timeforrehab.com.
Now, surveys and studies and such brought to you by BetterCreditCards.com. A survey of 2,000 people finds 6 in 10 have felt the urge to try something outside their comfort zone during the pandemic. That urge may be because the average person hasn't tried new things in months. And for 12%, it's been over a year since they've tried something new. So have you felt like doing something different or trying something different lately at all? Or no, is that not your thing?
No.
The other day, I'm
pretty content.
I was super excited to try some food that I hadn't tried in a long, long time. And you were just looking at me like I was nuts. You're like, you're going to eat that?
Because it was full of peppers and onions.
Spicy stuff.
And tomatoes.
And I'm not known for that. I tried it and I liked it.
No, I put anything like that in any of my food at home. And you
don't.
Gag
Please
and you
don't.
Sputter and you spit. So guess what I'm cooking with now?
Hey, a new study finds college-educated women are more likely than ever to give birth to their first child out of wedlock. So more than ever. Not sure why. Surveys and studies and such brought to you by BetterCreditCards.com.
Do you have a credit card? We'd like to help you get a better credit card. If you don't have any credit cards, we'd like to help you too. At BetterCreditCards.com, we have credit cards that offer different things for different people. Some cards offer points. Some cards are designed to help you build your credit. BetterCreditCards.com wants to help you get a better credit card, no matter what you're looking for. See if we can help you find a better credit card at BetterCreditCards.com. That's BetterCreditCards.com.
This is Your Brain on Drugs, brought to you by TimeForRehab.com. Police have arrested a man that they say committed several acts of arson at multiple different Circle K locations around Phoenix. 61-year-old Dennis Ray Barrett was arrested August the 28th. He allegedly set fire to a trash can inside three different convenience stores. I don't know why he did this. July 31st, he reportedly set fire to a trash can at one location, then ran out of the store with some stolen beer. Oh, that's what he was up to.
Issuing a distraction.
Yeah, so he set fires in other cans and then fled with more stolen beer. So that was his thing.
Yeah.
He would set the fires as a distraction. Each incident, he would grab some booze and take off running. Anyway, again, did I mention?
Strange things are afoot at the Circle K.
He's 61.
Jeez.
He still got arrested. It's a bad idea.
It's pretty spry for 61.
Three counts of arson, by the way. Don't do that. It's a bad idea. That is what happens when your brain is on drugs.
John and Heidi.
Now, big screen, little screen, brought to you by ChannelSurferTV.com. I'm excited. Later this month, I'm going to be visiting with a guy who has written a book called The Bond Experience. It's about James Bond. And I've got a new Bond movie that's finally coming out. But I've got a couple of stories here, three of them. No Time to Die has a new release date. It's finally going to come out on the 25th I'm sorry, the 25th James Bond film will come out on September 28th. That's what I meant to say. But that's 30 days later than it was originally supposed to come out. So it was originally released, supposed to be released back in 2019.
Oh,
and then it got pushed back.
Yep.
And it got pushed back for other reasons. Then it hit the pandemic.
Okay.
And then it was one of the first films to be delayed because of the pandemic. In April of 2020, it got pushed back. Anyway, they've had a lot of struggles to get it done. It's done. It's ready. It's going to be coming soon. And one other story here says James Bond has wrestled out The Rock to become the world's highest paid movie star. Daniel Craig's Netflix streaming deal for Knives Out sequels have netted him an estimated $100 million.
Wow.
Twice as much as second place, Dwayne The Rock Johnson. With Will Smith and Denzel coming in third with $40 million apiece, Jennifer Lawrence and Julia Roberts tied for the highest earning female actors, $25 million apiece.
Really?
Yeah, $25 million. And again,
Julia Roberts, that one surprises me.
Yeah. So there you go. That is Big Screen, Little Screen, brought to you by ChannelSurferTV.com.
At WeirdGiftOfTheDay.com, we help you get ready for all the fun holidays throughout the year with fun, silly, and just plain weird gift ideas for your friends. If you have a friend who has a bizarre sense of humor, we've got a gift for them. WeirdGiftOfTheDay.com posts a link to something that will make you smile each and every day. Whether you buy these weird gifts or not, it's worth checking out just for a smile. WeirdGiftOfTheDay.com. That's WeirdGiftOfTheDay.com.
Now your scoop of the day comes your way, courtesy of BetterCreditCards.com. New Jersey student has said he is barred from taking classes at Rutgers University because he does not want to be vaccinated. But here's the tricky thing.
I read this.
He's studying virtually from home.
Yep, I read this.
And he's going, I'm not even going to be at your place. And they're like, nope. You can't do it unless you get
not okay.
So I just think that's really bizarre. I could see it if he was going to be on campus, but they're going, nope. Even though you're not going to be on campus, if you're going to get Rutgers University handed over to you on a diploma, you need to do this.
That's a bunch.
Well, it's just very bizarre is what it is.
Yep.
A gang of masked thieves in Minnesota stole 17 cars from a car dealership.
Jeez.
Yeah, 17 cars. And the story says, well, at least they're wearing their mask. The Aldi supermarket chain has created a new line of alcohol-flavored cheeses. What?
You know I'm going to be trying them.
Heidi's going to be like, I got to run to Aldi and get me some of that. Mercedes has created a car that can read a driver's mind and adjust its controls accordingly to their thoughts. That's a bad idea. Especially if you daydream while you're driving. You're like, oh.
But if you're dreaming about running somebody over, you're like, oh, I can't stand. I'm going to run her over.
Honk your car at me. Cars leaping towards them. All right. Instead of having to worry about jellyfish or sharks on the beach, beachgoers in Corsica have to keep their eyes out for cows. Yeah, the cows have taken over the beaches there in the Mediterranean island. And they're not friendly cows. Corsica has more than 15,000 cows that apparently think they own the place. After not seeing many beachgoers the last year, they've taken over. One man was sent to the hospital. He was gored in the neck by a cow.
Geez.
Well, that would have probably been a bull. Anyway, in town, cows have been spotted chasing tourists down the street, and a woman was airlifted to the hospital after suffering a severe leg wound from a cow attack. She was hanging her laundry to dry when it happened.
Oh, my
cows
gosh.
Have been seen rampaging throughout picnics. Before you laugh, that mental picture, keep this in mind. These cows have horns, which, again, would make these cows bulls, but there you go. Thanks for listening to the John and Heidi Show.
Early to bed, early to rise makes you healthy, wealthy, and wise. This is a great quote from Benjamin Franklin. At InsuranceChicken.com, we know a thing or two about great quotes. We help people get great insurance quotes every day. It's super simple and free to find out if we can make you healthy, wealthy, and wise. Okay, I can't guarantee that. But I can assure you we'd love to help at InsuranceChicken.com. We want to help you pack out great deals on insurance. That's InsuranceChicken.com.
Thanks for listening to the John and Heidi Show on a Movie Star Monday. Our guest today is Susan Anton, been in a bunch of movies and also several TV shows like Baywatch and more. And she's got a new show out now. It's called Idle Chat, and we're going to chat with her about it now. Susan, how are you doing today?
I'm very good. good. How are you doing today?
I am excited to chat with you. You've got this new program, Idle Chat, and this thing is kind of just kicking off right now. Let's talk a little bit about the show and where people can find Idle Chat.
Well, alrighty. Idle Chat is a reunion show that your listeners can check out on Retro TV and the Family Channel, as well as itsrealgoodtv.com. It's a reunion show of all these iconic casts of music, film, television from the 60s and 50s and 70s, and every shows that we've all watched and loved along the way, whether it's Happy Days, Leave It to Beaver, the wonderful singing group, the Pointer Sisters, you know, Lost in Space, Sid and Marty Krofft, Knots Landing. I mean, just really, there's 8 episodes, 8 different casts that we shot at the Hollywood Museum, and it's a chance for people to catch up with these iconic stars from shows that we've all known and loved.
And I think that's a really neat idea, and I believe the first episode is Leave It to Beaver, is that right?
It is, and it was so much fun for me because I'd never met either one of Jerry Mathers or Tony Dow, and then we interviewed Steve Talbot, who played Gilbert, via Zoom. It was really great because I loved Leave It to Beaver as a kid growing up, and I had such a mad crush on Tony Dow, who is still adorable today, you know, and Jerry Mathers, he even brought his red hat that he used to wear as Beaver, which was incredible to see the original red hat.
And I love that even this show is streaming in a way that I can go on and watch it when I have time. That's just a whole different way to watch TV. I had seen episodes of Leave It to Beaver that I had never seen in syndication. But then when I was watching them, I don't even remember which streaming service, but I was watching it on there. And you can go back and watch like the very first episode. I had never seen the very first episode before.
Well, I don't know that I saw the first one either. I have to go back and find that. When I knew I was going to be interviewing all of these wonderful people, I went online. Like you said, it's so great because I can just pull it up and go like, okay, let me refamiliarize myself with the tone and the time and what they were talking about, the subject matters. You know, the thing about like Leave It to Beaver is what they're talking about in these shows is still current today.
Yeah.
And it was the first show that was through the eyes of the kids on the show. And, you know, the kids have all the wisdom, which I think is important for us to remember today. We need to listen to our youth and hear what's going on.
Now, it's really fun that you get to host this, and you're talking to the stars of all of these TV shows, and you get to ask them all the fun questions. But there are probably a ton of people that would like to ask you a lot of fun questions from the TV shows and the movies you've been a part of. So when you get to meet people, like, out in the wild, what's the show or the movie that people bring up to you the most, Susan?
Oh, well, a lot of people want to know, you know, what it was like touring with Kenny Rogers. Did he really do practical jokes? And I said, yeah, he did. People are curious about the movie Golden Girl, where I played an Olympic runner, and they want to know if I still have the gold shorts. Which I said, no, I got rid of those, and I definitely don't run anymore. And then everybody wants to know about Dudley Moore. You know, Dudley and I dated for quite some time, and we were such an odd pairing, given that I'm 5'11", he's 5'2". You know, people are always curious to know about personal life as well as professional life.
And you had a couple of years on Baywatch, and then there's some fun movies that you've... I love the fact that you did Sharknado 4. For whatever reason, I just love those shows. And was it fun to be a part of the cast of Sharknado 4?
Well, it was hysterical, because I had no idea what a big cult thing it was. They were shooting it in Vegas, and so they asked all of the different people that, you know, live and work here in Las Vegas, you know, if they'd come down and do a little bit. And I said, yeah, sure, okay. I had no idea, and to this day, you know, there's so many people. They go, oh, I saw you in Sharknado. I'm in the opening credits for like 5 seconds. But they know.
It's one of those things. Well, you're going to have the same thing with this new program, I believe, Idle Chat. And the first season is out now, but do you plan on doing more? Do you guys have other shows you'd like to feature as well?
Well, we are hoping, you know, hopefully this initial launch will go really well and we can start to work on our next season. And I personally would like to reunite the cast of Baywatch.
Yeah.
I think it'd be really fun to get together with everybody that was a part of that, you know, iconic show.
I agree completely. I'm going to throw a link to make it easy to find this show. Thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you so much, and you take care.
Absolutely. And again, if you'd like to find more information about Idle Chat, I've got a link to all of the information in the show notes for today at johnandheidishow.com.
Addiction. It's not a pretty thing. Addiction can lead to many problems in your life. Addiction can drive away those who love you the most. And addiction can lead to the loss of jobs, relationships, and even your life. Don't let addiction tear your life apart anymore. Get the help you need to defeat addiction and put the pieces back together in your life. Learn more at timeforrehab.com. They want to help. Timeforrehab.com. That's timeforrehab.com.
Fun fact for you, Heidi.
What's that, John?
Wasps get aggressive toward the end of summer for a reason. You know why?
Why?
They get drunk on fermenting fruit hanging from trees.
Oh, funny.
So if you see a wasp that's, you know, all liquored up from the fruit that's hanging on the trees, they might sting you when they wouldn't typically do that.
Serious
otherwise.
Question. Do wasps serve any legitimate purpose?
I don't know. I really don't know. I know, like,
I mean,
bees,
I know bees do. I know, yeah, bees are, well, super important, but I don't know about wasps.
There's probably something. We don't know what it is, but there's probably something. But that's an interesting little fun fact. Now you know. Thanks for listening to the John and Heidi Show.
Do you have a credit card? We'd like to help you get a better credit card. If you don't have any credit cards, we'd like to help you too. At bettercreditcards.com, we have credit cards that offer different things for different people. Some cards offer points. Some cards are designed to help you build your credit. Bettercreditcards.com wants to help you get a better credit card, no matter what you're looking for. See if we can help you find a better credit card at bettercreditcards.com. That's bettercreditcards.com.
Now, radiotravelgroup.com presents a news headline from somewhere in this world. Dateline Israel. With one of the highest vaccination levels on the planet, Israel is now seeing the most, or some of the most, COVID cases,
yep,
per day since the start of the pandemic. So not, yep, exactly sure what all is going on there, but it's quite confusing to many. I have a link to the story if you want to read all the details, because I don't know all the details, but they are in the show notes for today at johnandheidishow.com.
At WeirdGiftOfTheDay.com, we help you get ready for all the fun holidays throughout the year with fun, silly, and just plain weird gift ideas for your friends. If you have a friend who has a bizarre sense of humor, we've got a gift for them. WeirdGiftOfTheDay.com posts a link to something that will make you smile each and every day. Whether you buy these weird gifts or not, it's worth checking out just for a smile. WeirdGiftOfTheDay.com. That's WeirdGiftOfTheDay.com.
Time now for some weird news brought to you by WeirdGiftOfTheDay.com. Weird story. When a naked man was spotted running through Lowe's home improvement department, people called the police. 38-year-old Kevin Lamont Cooper, the third, was arrested and charged with indecent exposure. When police arrived, they reported finding the nude man outside in a flower display, wearing only a towel at that time. He told officers he thought he was being followed by people who were threatening to kill him. The man said he was hiding behind a post when he heard his pants beginning to beep, and he thought somebody planted a bomb in his clothing, so he removed all of the clothing. When employees saw the naked man, they gave him a towel to cover up. Police, yikes, asked the man to get dressed. He said he was not going to. He thought his clothing was going to explode. They took him to a hospital for medical clearance before he was,
yeah,
booked in the county jail.
That's unfortunate.
That really is. I'm praying for that dude. That sounds like he's got something going on. It is today's weird news, brought to you by WeirdGiftOfTheDay.com. Time now for your moment of duh, brought to you by BetterResultsAdvertising.com. A barbershop owner shot and wounded a masked gunman who entered his shop Saturday and pointed a firearm at several people.
Good for him.
The shooting occurred at 3:25 in the afternoon in a strip mall on Florida Avenue in Melbourne, Florida. 24-year-old Palm Bay resident Marlon Masco was shot in the hip. He was disarmed and apprehended at the scene. He showed up because they said it was not a robbery, but it was related to a prior haircut transaction where he was not happy.
Not pleased.
He came back with a gun and a plan. He's now being charged with aggravated assault with a firearm. He's lucky to be alive because he came in pointing a gun, swinging the gun around, and the guy at the barbershop
could have shot to kill.
Yeah, he shot him instead. So what in the world? Don't do that. It's today's moment of duh.
Early to bed, early to rise makes you healthy, wealthy, and wise. This is a great quote from Benjamin Franklin. At InsuranceChicken.com, we know a thing or two about great quotes. We help people get great insurance quotes every day. It's super simple and free to find out if we can make you healthy, wealthy, and wise. Okay, I can't guarantee that, But I can assure you we'd love to help at insurancechicken.com. We want to help you pack out great deals on insurance. That's insurancechicken.com.
Time now for Is It a Golf Course or Is It a Rehab Center? Brought to you by timeforrehab.com. Heidi, are you ready?
Here we go. Yeah.
Let's see. How about this one right here? University Ridge in Verona, Wisconsin. University Ridge. Is it a golf course or is it a rehab center?
This is a golf course.
Yes, it is. Golf course.
There we go. Two in a row again.
You're back on track.
I am.
I don't want to like jinx here or anything, but you could go all the way.
I could. I really could.
Or you could mess it up tomorrow, but we'll hope you can. All right. Not too much pressure. That is how we play. Is it a golf course or is it a rehab center? Brought to you by timeforrehab.com.
John and Heidi.
This portion of the John and Heidi Show is brought to you by the John and Heidi Show. That sounds kind of funny, but it's true. Go to your local radio station and ask them to start carrying the John and Heidi Show. Here's the best part. They can carry the show for free. They play a couple commercials, but it doesn't cost them anything every month. So if you know a radio station that could use a little bit of help, send them our way. Send them to johnandheidishow.com. Again, johnandheidishow.com. We would love to do a radio program in your community. Then you could listen to the podcast and listen to us on the radio.
John and Heidi.
We always like to wrap things up around here with good news, and I think this is good news. It comes your way courtesy of bettercreditcards.com. I love this story. Boys hop off their bikes to pay respect during a veteran's funeral.
Oh.
This is so great. Two boys in Indiana immediately stopped their bicycles and hopped off their bicycles when a funeral procession for an 89-year-old Army veteran passed by them. This is really nice, and this is something that doesn't always happen. I am absolutely ashamed.
I am amazed at the number of cars that don't stop.
I've seen funeral processions. You pull over, and there's people honking at you, wanting you to go. I'm like, there's a funeral. What are you doing? Anyway, Jackie Hornock said she witnessed this heartwarming scene while she was at a friend's house. She was a little hesitant on whether or not to actually snap a photo and post it online, but she decided, you know what? I think I need to. People need to see this.
Yeah.
So I debated whether or not to post this, but with all the negative things going on in the world, I thought this was needed.
Absolutely.
She said these two boys were riding their bicycles. They saw the flag of the deceased military man. They immediately stopped riding their bikes. They got off their bike, and they stood with respect as taps was being played.
Oh.
And there's a photo of these two boys, and I love this. The bicycles were parked on the side of the road. They stood there with their arms behind their back, and they just stood right next to each other, paying their respects. That is so cool.
And you know, I don't get choked up by much, but I get choked up by taps. Every time.
These two young boys immediately stopped, paid their respects, and passed to the past servicemen without prompting, without knowledge
That's
of anybody
beautiful.
Watching.
That
they didn't know they were
beautiful.
Being photographed. She said it was just touching to see that. And I'm really glad that she did get a photo.
And good job, mom and dad.
Yeah. Somebody did a good job there raising. And if you got kiddos, here's the thing. Have a conversation with them about that. About what you're supposed to do. Because there are a lot of people that don't know.
A lot of young people who have no idea.
Have no clue. They're like, why in the world are we pulling over? You know, so that's like, it's a good discussion to have. Time to say goodbye, Heidi.
Goodbye, Heidi.
Goodbye, everybody. Have a great day. Thank you so much for listening to the John and Heidi Show on a Monday.